First, to stop transgender girls from participating in girls' sports have taken several new turns today.
At one point, lawmakers killed the bill, but tonight the issue is still alive. Catalan Stancitella was at the Capitol for all of the developments and looks ahead at what's next.
Lawmakers sent House Bill 1217 to the governor, and she sent it back to them with several recommended changes. This morning, the House of Representatives resoundingly rejected the governor's style and form veto.
For me to support this style and form veto would be an egregious violation of my oath to the Constitution, and so I will not do it. And I would suggest that you also vote no on these style and form changes. Thank you.
The governor then did not certify the legislation, essentially sending it back as a vetoed bill. An override would need two-thirds of lawmakers' support in both the House and Senate.
Where is justice if competition is not fair? We're talking specifically about sports and the science that backs up the physical differences in male and females. Not access to a public pool or service at a coffee shop, not even an educational or a job opportunity.
And we should be passing this bill, knowing we're on the right, and as we lead, other states will follow. Sometimes it takes just a few brave souls to step out in faith, and everyone else will follow.
But the House vote to override the veto came in with only 45 representatives, two short of the 47 needed. The bill was dead.
In my community and communities across South Dakota, what I heard pretty crystal clear was that school districts, teachers, administrators are doing a really good job of dealing with the issues of making sure our sports are competitive. And I didn't feel this was an issue where the legislature needed to tell school districts what to do.
We have to understand that these young trans girls are not boys. They're transitioning. They are not taking testosterone. They're taking hormone pills. They're human beings who just want to play.
Then, just before 5 o'clock, we learned from the governor's office that she is seeking a special session on the topic of transgender girls' participation in sports. Additionally, she is signing a pair of executive orders, one that says transgender girls in grades kindergarten through 12 shall not play in a sanctioned sporting event, and another saying that transgender college girls should not do so. Reporting in Pierre, Dan Centella, Keloland News.
We have the full text of House Bill 1217 and each of Governor Noem's executive orders in this report on Keloland.com.